Not Seven the Scientist, it's Professor Seven. Just doing this quick video, hopefully it won't be too long, but try to stay for the whole thing. One of the things, and this was inspired by Smurfy in 313. It's my girl. And we were talking, and then, you know, situations happened at this time, so I had some time to really take a moment. And one of the things in our conversation that just sparked me, made me think about Neil deGrasse Tyson, the scientist about the universe, and him and Terrence Howard, and, you know, how to me, it kind of reflected back to how I used to see people on YouTube thinking they this, and I always used to say, make sure you get your resources from authenticated and reputable people. I'm not going to even name drop no YouTubers here, but I used to see people, I don't know if they just viewing the troll or really thinking they dropping knowledge or information or to develop something new or anything. And it's good to be imaginable and, you know, and take that initiative and that intuitiveness to be creative. Not knocking that, but it's a source and a process. But check this out. I'm going to break it down for you with commentary. One moment, please.
Is given my most informed critical analysis that I can. In my field, we call that a peer review. You come up with an idea, you present it either at a conference or you first write it up and you send it to your colleagues. It is their duty to alert you of things about your ideas that are either misguided or wrong, or there's a miscalculation that doesn't work out, or the logic doesn't comport. That's their job. Not all ideas will turn out to be correct. Most won't be. But to get to that point, you need to know things like, what has everyone else said about this same subject? Am I repeating someone else's work? Is this a new insight that no one else has had, but has foundations that are authentic or legitimate or objectively true? Am I making a false assumption? Am I making an assumption that someone else has already shown to be false? All of this goes on the frontier of science.
Science applies to life in so many different ways, like science of the mind. I just say, you have to listen to people and get your information from reputable, authenticated people. People who go through licenses and certifications and higher teachings and do have a body of people around them that can keep them in check and balances of what's up to date or what's not correctly being done. So, you know, I was never hating. I just teach mine, like, watch what you use. Don't get your TikTok information or YouTube information and think it's life-changing when it hasn't been proven or it's a lie or it may have already been said. Sometimes it's for entertainment and not for teaching. So just be aware.
You're right. But not enough about that subject to know that you're wrong. And so there's this sort of valley in there, a valley of false confidence. This has been studied by others, and it's called the Dunning-Kruger effect. It's the phenomenon where a little bit of knowledge, you over-assess how much of that subject you actually know. And then when you learn even more, you realize, no, I didn't know as much as I thought I did. So then there's a sort of a lull there. And then when you learn even more, you come back up. Ultimately, learning enough to know whether you were right or wrong. To become an expert means you spend all this time. It doesn't happen overnight. You can't just sit in an armchair and say, I'm now an expert. It requires years and years of study, especially looking through journals where new ideas are published and contested. That's what we have learned is the most effective means of establishing that which is objectively true, or determining that which is objectively false. Both of those work hand in hand to move the needle on our understanding of the universe.
If you really want to know the truth, you have to do your own research. But again, just saying, watch who you listen to.
That is a clear indication of a restless, active mind. Within these pages, however, there are many assumptions and statements that are underinformed, misinformed, or simply false, thereby compromising or nullifying many of the subsequent conclusions you have drawn. That's exactly what should happen in a peer review, out of respect for one another's intellect.
Out of respect for each other's intellect, if you have it. And that's the whole point, man. The cancel culture and everything, it's like we can't challenge each other. We can't tell the truth to each other. We're hurting each other's feelings telling the truth, or we're mean. I hear that a lot when I tell the truth. Or you're mean. I'm like, I'm telling you the truth. It's not being mean. It's just being truthful. Accept the truth. I do. I get mad about the truth sometimes, but I accept it.
To itself is greater than the initial number squared, for that would expose a loose thread within the fabric of our understanding, a loose thread capable of unraveling the very ground rules of mathematics. That's a bold statement. So then I just say, this opening thesis is false. There are plenty of examples of this that have escaped your attention. His statement is shown to be false for every number that's less than one and greater than zero. For example, the square root of 0.64 is 0.8. 0.8 is bigger than 0.64, and it's a larger number than the original. And 0.64 squared equals 0.4096, a smaller number than the original. To the extent that the next 35 pages depends on your stated thesis, this fact undermines your claims and assumptions and conclusions. It's not about feelings here. It's about objective reality. So at the time, I can...
Neil deGrasse Tyson was being very politically correct. He was being very nice. He was being very professional. He's being very real and honest to his capability of what he's learned and what he know. And he presented that. This is a thing that with the Terrence Howard thing.
To be misunderstood is not to be a genius. The work of Russell, Walter Russell, has eluded any experimental support. And the work of Keeley is generally not reproducible. Science is about reproducibility. I can have the most brilliant, crazy, fun idea ever. And if I perform an experiment and no one else can duplicate that experiment, it belongs in the trash heap. It's me in my own world, thinking I have landed on an objective truth, when in fact I haven't. That's how science works. The reproducibility of results.
The reproducibility of results. That's the thing, man. Y'all have to listen to people. If someone's telling you something to invest in something and you're not able to, you know, reproduce the results that they're claiming, then basically they're
impractical. Just because you do some good stuff doesn't mean everything you ever did is going to be great. I will further affirm that just because an idea sounds crazy doesn't make it wrong. The system of research and publications in peer-reviewed journals has the capacity to spot crazy but true ideas, provided they're supported by compelling arguments and ultimately supported by experiments and observations. Newton's laws, Einstein's relativity, quantum physics were all revolutionary ideas that appeared in peer-review settings or journals. Meanwhile, most of the work of...
This depends on the situation, this whole thing here. But again, if people telling you something, they're the only one telling you, and they're in a particular, they're talking about a particular field of professionals, and the people that's professionals in the field that they're talking about don't agree with them, then again, I can't say they're lying, but they're just generally may be wrong.
The fact, I don't think of that as trashing. I think of that as being honest. I could have softened it, but I don't think that's what people who care about you should do. People who care will be honest with you about ideas, about thoughts.
I saw the Star Talk, my response with Deanne Tyson here. It's very interesting. He talked about a lot of stuff, a lot of subjects that I used to see people on YouTube talk about and debate about, and all the conscious community thing and all that, and hating science, just hate the sciences. Y'all just hate the sciences.
So, in case people wanted to know what actually went down 8 years ago, just always be cautious of the Dunning-Kruger effect. You put in a little bit of work and you have an idea, and then you think your idea is right, and that Einstein is wrong, and Newton is wrong, and that everybody's wrong, and that all of modern astrophysicists are wrong. That's bold. That's bold. Audacious. Bodacious.
Again, this is a good point. Just not with the situation between them. Just life itself, man. When people say things, say claims, or say things about situations or people, and it's wrong or not true, and you stand on it, that's pretty bold. It's like you standing on a lie.
Attention can be given on a level that at the end of the day offers no higher respect for your energy and intellect than by declaring that what's in it is either right or wrong or worthy of publication or not. I wanted to post this to my website.
And everything we do, we could be wrong, we could be right. We could put a lot of energy in a lot of things, especially relationships, and it turns out, you know, it wasn't right. But I think if you look at it, all your flaws and attention that you do things, you do find things that, you know, you learn from. You know, you learn from your mistakes. I hope you enjoyed that. Hold up, I got something I wrote. I will always have love in my heart. I am in a different space now. Focus on priorities to get goals completed. I am not happy with some things in my life, but I'm happy with my life. It will always be people, certain situations that may be beyond your control for that moment. It's how you react and navigate at those times that can give you a favorable outcome. It's hard to be a godly man, a good man, a humble person, a fair, ethical person with morals. No matter what it is, another person whose ethics and morals may be different, even inhumane or evil, without regards or remorse, and may feel just as strong as you. The humble, kind, caring, peaceful, hard-working person who may be powerful but uses other means than fear, control, or manipulation to leverage their agenda. S-O-A-K. Soak on that. I view things different. I'm not like most in my thinking and observations. I move based off experiences, my heart and spirit. Now I live where I try to do the right things and what's best, not just for the moment, but future. I try to think ahead and predict outcomes by my experience, research, data, whatever. Yeah, a single dad raising a daughter. Full custody, no child support. Her host, an abuser, overuser, overindulger. Gobble it, swallow it, quick to make sure they get enough, or if not, get it all. Greedy for a fix, then they cannot quit. Binge for years and then be sober for a month, then gone again. See, I live with the fear and the tears of young Seven. So this whole thing with the host was a hoax. She wasn't even my type. But my flesh, it won the fight. You know, people coax and coerce me. Like, bro.
They're still good though. Maybe some lime and yo. Make a nigga say big words and act lyrical. Make me get spiritual. Make me believe in miracles. Buddha's monks and Captain Crunch cereal. Lord have mercy. Down, I hurt me. Five buddies all hurdled up on the third day. Bottle service, head service. I came in first place. The opportunity, the proper top of breast and booty cheek. The pop community. I mean, these bitches come with union feet. And I want two of these. Moving units through consumer streets. Then my shoe release. She was kicking in gratuity. And yeah, G, I was all for it. She said, K. Lamar, you kinda dumb to be a boy. I'ma put you on game for the names that don't know they're a rookie. Instagram is the best way to promote some pussy.
In conclusion, I campaigned, politicked, threatened, pleaded, told stats and facts to peel Young Seven's cap before the birth, Roe versus Wade. So I took the fade, the shade, and decided Young Seven I'll raise. So it's my decision alone, this life of ours. It has already been written, thought out, played in my mind for so long. I now embrace it and will follow the script. I pray to the Most High. May God always guide, bless, and protect, and keep a watchful eye. Seven's Wrath.